The digital currency is taking over. Central bank digital currencies, CBDCs, are the digital form of a government-issued currency that isn't pegged to a physical commodity. They are issued by central banks, whose role is to support financial services for a nation's government and its commercial banking system, set monetary policy, and issue currency.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Amadai Shakur. It looks like the U.S. is in a bit of trouble. Perhaps they're finally getting beat at their own game. Let's get into it. In a historic move, China has brokered peace between Iran and the Saudis. They're likely not going to be using the U.S. dollars anymore as their international reserve currency. Pay attention. And if that's the case, the U.S. dollar is going to be worth even less than it is right now. It's not even going to be backed by oil. And so pretty much nothing more than monopoly money. This move is definitely going to benefit Putin. And don't forget that he's already paid off all of Africa's debt. With that all being said, those sanctions that the U.S. tried to impose on everyone that doesn't do what they say, when they say, and how they say it, it's not going to go so well for them this time. Our economy is going to be further down the tank. This is going to be a real-life Hunger Games that we're living in. And I can't help but think that they're going to roll out that digital currency and we'll have no choice but to go ahead and comply because we'll be so desperate. People are not going to be able to afford food. Everything's going to be in complete and utter chaos. At the end of the day, the United States brought this on themselves. Pay attention. In a move that I consider to be an act of complete and utter desperation, they sent Kamala Harris over to Africa to try to mend relationships with the continent. But I don't think that's going to work. You see, no one has forgotten what they did to Saddam Hussein and Muammar Gaddafi. At the end of the day, the United States thought they were playing the game. But the only thing they were doing was playing checkers while the other nations were allying themselves against them and clearly playing chess. Iran says that U.S. interference has created regional unrest, sanctions are driving a domestic crisis, and Shamkhani says this will no longer be tolerated. Now there are talks of the Saudis and Iran joining BRICS, which now consists of Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. Let me tell you something. If all of these people get together and decide that they want to just turn on the United States, which is exactly what it looks like, all I can say is this. They better get ready for the smoke, and we better get ready to try and prepare to survive in this whole outlandish nightmare. This is going to be beyond.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it was shocking.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work... He starts a good work. He's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work. And he will surely see it through to the end. He says, it makes all things work together for good. For those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it explained today that I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, he is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. Got to believe that. In the book of Matthew's chapter 6 verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you, and he's brought it this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No, the Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, you will seek me. And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued, and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts zinga or zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impasses and zagalas, this is all. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sisley Rad. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this is the same thing that God says? Come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meaning is from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like, dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me. Because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, me the same skin taking over. Most things out of focus view, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Beautiful, ooh, 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 ooh. Dim and dim gon' fall. with you in all of your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. You dance and they can't come.